God's favor on your life will keep you from a whole lot of stuff. Anybody in here? Amen. God's favor on your life, not so much because of you, amen, but because of the grace that he has in those who care about you will keep you out of a whole lot of stuff, amen, that other people are dying in. Yeah, amen. God's grace, God's grace. Well, let me move on. Amen. Because you see, amen, the Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 2, amen, the Bible talks about, amen, us, amen, being dead in trespasses and sin, whom God has quickened, amen, made alive, and tells us all about being saved by grace. But he tells us, amen, he says, but some of you, amen, thank God, this was your lifestyle. You were past feelings. You were, amen, messed up. And we don't like for folk to talk about, amen, thank God, who we were and how we were, because we don't want anybody to know about that part of us. All we want them to know now is I'm saved and I'm sanctified. But sometimes you need to let folk know what you were saved from. Amen. You need to let folk know what God brought you out of. Thank God. Yeah, they need to know that what you see now, amen, thank God, I haven't always been this. Amen. Thank God, I was that repulsive caterpillar, amen, wrapped up in that cocoon and that web, amen, until grace came. And when grace came, grace took me out of that, amen, and made me a beautiful butterfly. Only grace can do that. Only grace. Listen and hear me. Amen. Think, I know it doesn't matter about how much you try to clean up your act and to clean up yourself. You are limited as to how far you can go. Amen. Thank God. It's going to take grace. God's grace, amen, to deliver us. God's grace to save us. God's grace to wash us. God's grace to sanctify us. God's grace to justify us. God's grace to glorify us. All is because of the grace of God. And so all of us that's saved in the house today, you can only say you're saved because of God's grace. Yeah, amen. The writer said, hey, we don't have anything to boast about in ourselves because we couldn't work enough, hallelujah, to be saved. We couldn't take enough good steps and help enough people and, amen, give enough money and all of that. You know, we have some people who do some great things, amen. They help charities and they do all of these things, amen, for religious reasons. But those things, well, there are no substitute for grace. When we get through doing all of that and all of that's good, amen, but we still need grace. And what simply says is, amen, that I must surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ. I must allow him to come into my life and into my heart. I need to allow him to sanctify my life, purify my mind, and put me on the right road. Yeah, amen. That's what Jesus came to do. Amen. That was his purpose for coming. So, amen. So when we look at this word grace and we think about that, it was undeserving favor. Amen. Thank God. And we think about it. We say, God, I thank you for your mercy. Amen. Thank God. I'm thanking you for your mercy because you spared me. What should have happened to me, you didn't let it happen. Amen. That's what mercy is. Amen. Thank God is what I should have gotten. You didn't let it happen. You pardoned you. You had mercy. You spared me. Amen. Kept me away from it. I wonder, has anybody in here ever stopped to think how many times God's mercy has spared us, amen, from stuff would have been devastating in our lives if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side. I'm going to be through here in just a few minutes. Amen. Thank God. But when I get to thinking about God's grace, amen, how merciful it is. Thank God. How many times, praise God, have you been driving down the road and it almost was in a serious accident? Amen. Thank God. But just in the nick of time, amen, God put his hand forth and spared your life, spared the family, spared the automobile, and just let you look and see. Hallelujah. That's God's grace. Hallelujah. Thank God. And so this is why, amen, the writer is trying to get us to understand that this is all about God's grace and how much God loves us. That God did not withhold anything from us. He gave us everything. Thank God. He didn't just give us something out of heaven. He gave us the best that heaven had to order. Amen. To give. Amen. The Bible said he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Now when we say his only begotten son, we are talking about Jesus was unique. There was no other son born like him. Hallelujah. He was unique. He was the only one of his kind, and God gave him, oh God, so that we could have eternal life. Amen. Thank God. And so, amen. So he tells us that this is the grace of God. We're walking in God's grace. Everything that we do is because the grace of God. The Bible tells us, amen, thank God, that through his grace, we have peace with God. Amen. The Bible said God was angry with the wicked every day. So Jesus became our peace. He became the peacemaker. He became the one, amen, to reconcile us back to God. He brought, amen, amen, mediation between us when we were enemies. He made us friends again. Amen. And he didn't do this because we were good. He did it because of his grace. Amen. Thank God. You are not where you are because you've been so skillful or because, amen, thank God, you got it all together. You are where you are because of God's grace. Amen. I'm all in favor of education. I'm all in favor, amen, of bettering oneself. But don't forget who it was that gave you the grace to do that. Amen. Don't forget, amen, who it was that gave you the grace to go to the job, the grace, amen, to work the 12 or 13 hours, amen, every day for 7 days a week. It was God's grace that allowed that. If he had not given us the grace, we would never have been able to perform it. Therefore, we ought to just take a moment and say, Lord, I thank you for your amazing grace. Because I could not have made it if it had not been for you. Yeah, amen. Thank God. Now, folk will think you're crazy when you start thinking like this. When you start thinking about, amen, where would I be without his grace? Because everybody basically now is boasting in themselves. They're boasting about what they have and what they got and how they got it. Amen. Thank God. And all of that. But they don't ever let God have the glory. Amen. They pat themselves on the back. Amen. And give themselves accolades and praise. And, amen. But they never say, I have what I have because of the grace of God. Amen. Thank God there was no way that I could have accomplished what I had accomplished if it had not been for the grace of God. Now let me move to the next part here, because the Bible said grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. So now what the believer says, when the believer recognizes grace, amen, the believer goes, amen, to Romans chapter 8, amen, and you hear the Bible said there is therefore now. Hallelujah. I done look back. If you look at chapter 7, amen, there's a lot of stuff there to tell you about what I came out of. But now when I arrive in chapter 8 and I look back at chapter 7, I can say there is therefore now. Amen. Not going to be, but now. Amen. Right now in the present, there is therefore now no judgment, no condemnation to them who, amen, are in Christ Jesus, right? Amen. This is where great, let's say it another way, for them who are in grace. Thank God. Says there's no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus, because now they are not walking after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Amen. For the law of the Spirit of life has made me free from the law of sin and death. Amen. So now he's saying, amen, I was living under condemnation. I was living under the judgment of God. I was living, amen, under a threat of annihilation, but grace came. And when grace came and gave me a new start. And therefore I can look back at my past. My past cannot dominate my life. My past cannot control my present or my future. When I look back at my past, I can look at my present and say, said, there is therefore now, because of grace, I'm no longer a sinner. Because of grace, I'm no longer in bondage. Because of grace, amen, I'm no longer, amen, under the influence of the enemy. Thank God, God has granted me grace. Yeah, amen. Thank God. So he says, amen, that there is no condemnation. The devil can't condemn me any longer. He can accuse, but he can't condemn me. Amen. Because there is therefore now. I thank God for now. Amen. I thank God not for yesterday. I thank God for now. Amen. I thank God because I know so many. Amen. Thank God who started in this way when I did. They are no longer here. Now I'm going to tell you something about the grace of God. You can frustrate God's grace. You can take God's grace in vain. Thank God, but it's still grace.
Yes, Lord.
Taking it in vain is not using it and applying it, amen, for which it was ordered to do. Amen. Thank God. So there are some folks who start out in God's grace. Amen. Thank God, but fall by the wayside. And when they fall by the wayside, problems start entering into their lives. Troubles start coming in. They start having things happen that wasn't happening ordinarily. Amen. Thank God. And so he said, Paul says, I do not take the grace of God in vain. I don't just hear it and don't do anything about it. Amen. Thank God. When I hear about the grace of God, my heart comes to attention and my mind, amen, is illuminated by the will and power of God, of what God is doing in my life. And I understand now, amen, that I've come this far by grace. Grace has brought me through, amen, through the times of hardship, through the times of trouble, through the shelter of the storms, amen. Grace has always been present. So therefore, I'm going to give God praise for his grace. Yeah, amen. Thank God, grace, amen, has brought me thus far, and grace will lead me on. Thank you, Lord, for grace. It is God's amazing grace. Well, what does the Bible say about it? The Bible says, amen, concerning his grace, the Bible tells us that Jesus, amen, made himself of no reputation, and that he came down, amen, as a man into the world. First of all, he thought it not robbery to be equal with God. Amen. Secondly, he made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a man. Amen. And then the Bible said he became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. He had to submit himself unto death because death couldn't take him. Amen. Thank God. Death, amen, had to wait until he submitted to death. I thank God for grace. Hallelujah. If the devil had his way, hallelujah, you and I would have been wiped off planet Earth long time ago. If you believe that, give God a praise and shout hallelujah. But thank God for grace. Thank God for the grace that rides in the automobile with us. Thank God for the grace that goes down the streets when we're walking. Thank God for the grace in the supermarket. Thank God for the grace on the job. Thank God for the grace in the home. Everything I have is because of the grace of God. And I should never leave home, amen, unless God's grace is with me. Somebody give God a praise and tell him thank you. Well, let's just watch what happened to the prodigal son. The prodigal son left home. Amen. Packed his stuff, got his bags, and left home. His father didn't argue with him. Amen. The father gave him what was rightfully his. The Bible said he went, amen, into a far country. Amen. Thank God. And parted and wasted his living with rowdiness. Parting and having a good time. Thank God. And not thinking about what life is bringing forth, because somewhere along the line you're going to run into some tough times. Don't let anybody fool you. Your life is not going to be one big party. Amen. You're going to have some tests. You're going to have some drawbacks. You're going to have some failures along the way. So, amen, he spent all of his money. Amen. Thank God until he didn't have anything left. The Bible says then a famine hit the land. And so he had to go join himself to a citizen of that country. Amen. And after being there for a while, he began to feed the swines, amen, of a farmer in the country. The Bible said it got so bad until he was watching the hogs eat in the pig pen, and he was, amen, tempted to eat the husks of the corn that the hogs ate. But then he remembered grace. He done strayed a long ways, children, but he then remembered grace, and he began to say, how many hired servants my father has back at home, and here I am in the pig pen, amen, about to eat with the hogs. He said, I'm going to make up my mind, and I'm going to go home. Now, just making up his mind to go home was not enough, because see, when he get home, whoever's at home got to receive him. Thank God, that's where grace comes in. It was good of him to have a mind that he want to go home. But can you actually say, when I get home, thank God, is my father going to take me back? Is my father going to welcome me back in? Is my father going to hold my past over my head? Is he going to talk about, amen, I should have stayed when I was here? Thank God, you're a hard-headed boy. I tried to tell you, amen, but you wouldn't listen. But notice what the Bible said. The Bible said he got up. And got his speech together. He said, I'm going back home. And when I get home, I'm going to tell my father, I'm going to confess and say, Father, I've sinned against heaven, and I've sinned before you, and I'm no more worthy to be called your child. But just make me as one of your hired servants. I'll be satisfied just being a servant. You don't have to recognize my sonship, but just make me a servant. But the Bible said grace. I saw him coming afar off. And this is where this amazing grace come from. Saw him coming afar off. Amen. Thank God. And the Father went out to meet him with open arms. That's what grace will do. God don't hold your past against you. He just want to know if you're ready now to straighten up and fly right. If you believe it, give God a praise in the house. And tell God thank you. He's not going to bring up the stuff that you did. He gonna welcome you in with open arms. So he got to his father and started confessing and said, Father, I've sinned against heaven, that I've sinned before thee, and I'm not worthy to be called your child, but make me as one of your hired servants. The father didn't pay any attention to what he was saying. The father called for the servant and said, bring me a robe. Oh, that's what grace want to do, is robe you in righteousness. Grace want to robe you in love. Grace want to wrap his arms around you and soothe all of your sorrows and calm all of your fears. Grace want to bind up the broken heart and heal the wounded spirit. Grace want to bring you out of darkness into the marvelous light. Grace want to make you rich where you've been poor. Give God a hand praise and tell God thank you. Grace hallelujah, want to pick you up and give you a new lease on life. Grace want to turn your world right side up. Grace want to give you a new mind and a new heart. Grace want to put stability in you. Yeah, you've been bouncing all over the place, but I tell you something about grace. When trouble comes, God will give you the grace. You don't have to fret about hardship. You don't have to fret about trials. You don't have to fret about tribulations. You don't have to fret about challenges, because God's grace is enough. And God got enough grace to save everybody in the world. He got enough grace to take care of your situations that's sitting right here today. You got enough grace, thank God, to take care of us. He said to Paul, when Paul said, I talked to him about the infirmity that I have, and he just told me, Paul, my grace is enough. Let me just tell you, no challenge that come your way is bigger than God's grace. Let me just tell you, no storm can overwhelm you that's bigger than God's grace. God got enough grace to cover you from head to toe. God got enough grace to shield your home. and shield your family. God got enough grace to bring you through. If you believe it, give God a praise and shout hallelujah. Oh, glory. It is by His grace, it's by His grace that we've come this far. It was the grace of God that kept us last night and woke us up this morning. It was the grace of God that clothed us in our right mind. It was the grace of God that blessed us to come here. We don't know what was in our way on our way here. We don't have any idea. I had a writer said through seen and unseen danger. There were some things I did see, but thank God for the things I didn't see. He didn't allow me to see it because His hand was between me and what the devil wanted to do. His hand was between you and what the devil had planned for you. So you can say, through it all, He brought me out. He didn't allow me to see something that would upset my day. He didn't allow something to enter my path that would bind my heart with sorrow and with grief. I know it was out there, but God wouldn't allow it to happen. It is God's amazing grace. How sweet the sound. Give God a praise. Woo! Hallelujah. I thank God for grace. I don't know about you, but I'm living this life of grace, and I'm living it with confidence. I have no confidence in the flesh. I have no confidence in how smart my mind may tell me I am, but I trust in God. I believe in His grace. I don't believe He's going to let anything happen that's going to overwhelm me. The Bible says I'm not going to be tempted above that I'm able, but God is faithful, who has promised. He's not gonna let me be overwhelmed. So if He's in control, then why should I fear? Why should I be afraid? Why should I be troubled? Why should I sleep restless nights? Why should I live my life in fear? Because grace is enough for me, and God has promised to give me grace. Thank God for grace. I don't know why, but I wake up thinking about it. Maybe it's because I'm having birthdays, I don't know. Hallelujah. But I wake up thinking about it. I wake up thinking about it. When I walk around and I see others, thank God, my age. And I see how some are not my age. And I see how they're struggling. I see how their health is failing. I see how they are plagued with this and that. Thank God. And I said, thank you, Lord, for your grace. Oh, God, I thank you. There are some, and I'm not criticizing, thank God, who are living on medication. Thank God they have bags of it. Thank God, and still in pain. But you know what I said? Thank God. Hallelujah for grace. I thank you for the grace that keep my legs strong. I thank you for the grace that keep my mind sound. I thank you for the grace of strength in my body. I thank you, Lord, that none of these things you've let come on me. I believe it's because of your grace, because I'm not the only one that's living for you. There are others living for you, but they are not enjoying the grace that I'm enjoying. So thank God for grace. I recognize that by grace.
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father. Hallelujah. God, yes. By the grace of God.
Yes.
We're closing.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
But every day, I think about His grace.
Yes, Father.
All of the stuff that's happening in our world, people.
Yes. Thank you, Father.
That we just reading about and watching on TV.
Yes.
That could have been us. The only reason why it's not us is because of God's grace. Break-ins, robberies, murdering, all of that. It could have been us, because we've been in some of them same places where all that stuff was happening. But God held it back. Because of his grace, brother. Because of his grace. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. His grace is what kept us. And every time we can say, Lord, thank you,
thank you,
for your grace. I'm praying for those who was hit by it. But I thank you, my home is safe. I thank you, my children are safe. I thank you, there's shelter over their head. I thank you, you kept them. Some of them are out of my sight.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But I thank you for grace.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I thank you for grace.
Yes.
Amen. Lord, your eyes is on them.
Yes.
I can't watch them every second.
Yes, Lord.
Thank God. Ain't no way in the world I can tell you from minute to minute, play by play, what they're doing.
Yes, God. But you know. You know. You know.
But because of grace,
yes, Lord.
When I touch the hem of his garment, grace began to flow.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For your grace. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Evil is everywhere.
Thank you. Thank
but thank you,
Lord.
For grace.
Yes, Lord.
I will not neglect to give thanks for your grace.
Thank you, Jesus.
If I can get grace, I ain't worried about anything else.
Thank you.
If I get grace,
yes.
Hallelujah. If I get grace, I'm not worried about where I'm going to stay. Because God can put me under an umbrella and place me under the bridge. And if you give me grace, I'm going to be content.
Yes. Yes. Oh, bless you, Father.
Because I know.
Yes, Father.
This is not my destination. I'm just waiting for grace next assignment.
Yes.
Stand on your feet, we're getting ready to go.
Save the-